Hi, this is Ashok Motor Magazine. Today we are driving the Borgward BX5. It is a small SUV from Borgward, which some of you may remember as a historic brand that hasn't produced cars for over 50 years. Around 2010 or thereafter, the brand was resurrected by none other than the grandson of the original Mr. Borgward. So the brand has stayed in the family and they have got some assistance from China. More specifically, BAIC, Beijing Automotive Industry Corporation. With that assistance, they have managed to produce a range of models. The BX7 is a medium-sized SUV, then you have the BX6. They did a concept called the Borgward Isabella, which is of course named after their iconic classic car, but the concept didn't really make production. However, these SUVs did. And today we are in the BX5, which is, as I mentioned before, a small SUV. It's got a 1.4-litre turbocharged four-cylinder engine that puts out a fairly usable 148 bhp along with, I believe, 250 newton meters. I may be wrong there, that's what I recall reading in the specs earlier, which are both figures that make for more than enough power and torque in the Sri Lankan driving context. Now, having driven this under all three of its modes, which is normal driving mode, sports mode, as well as the eco mode, I have to say that between normal and sport, there isn't a big difference. Under both modes, the car will accelerate well if you give it enough throttle, and the engine revs all the way up to 5,500 rpm. You do get a kick in the back, if you will, more than enough useful power. Select eco mode and the throttle response is dulled, and you can drive in an economical fashion. However, if you want power, you can still access it by engaging the kickdown switch at the bottom of the throttle pedal. The interior is quite nicely made. I mean, there are styling cues from several other manufacturers as well here, but that is the name of the game nowadays. You have wood trim on the dashboard, you have a climate control system single zone, you have a very comprehensive multimedia suite that has Android Auto and Apple CarPlay on board, as well as provision for Bluetooth tethering to your phone. The radio is there, there's an aux port along with two USB charging ports down in a little compartment by the gear lever. And you also have something that we haven't seen in cars in a very long time, a cigarette lighter. So that tells you of its intended market, because this car is sold in Europe as well as several Asian markets. You have another 12-volt charging port in the center console box on which I can rest my arm as well. So all in all, it has got the set of features that the modern car buyer will want. So that is the Borgward BX5 for you. If we look around the cabin at some of the conveniences you get, you have quite a few door pockets, nooks and crannies for your stuff. In the rear also there are some pockets where you could put a phone or tablet or whatever you like. There's also a full-length sunroof above me, of which the front half can be opened. And it seems to be thermal glass, because we are driving with the cover off and still we are not feeling warm. Of course, the AC is doing a good job as well. I have to point out and say that this AC is pretty cold and fairly well developed for our climate.